welcome everyone, a new episode of Money Means Business. Today, the core of our episode is going to be totally dedicated to Ras Al Hikmah, to this peninsula, which is going, inshallah, to enjoy massive investments, mega projects. It's going to be totally renovated and it's going to turn into one of the most important tourism hubs, not only in the Middle East, but I think in the whole world. We are going to discuss the details of the deal, about the sums of money which are going to be invested there, about the two sides of the agreement, about the statements which were released by both sides, particularly by Prime Minister Dr. Mustafa Madbouly after witnessing the signing, all this and more in our rich special episode with my dear guest live here in the studio. But before we go into these details, let's watch together some details about the deal and we are going to turn back with more.
We'll be right back.
let's start immediately, and we are going to start with welcoming my dear guest live here in the studio, His Excellency Ambassador Ayoub Mahmoud Ayoub, former commercial minister. Thank you very much for being with us, sir.
Good evening to you and to the viewers.
And let's start, as I said, immediately with this very big, massive signing or deal which was signed recently between Egypt and the United Arab Emirates. As on Friday, Egypt signed this investment agreement with the UAE to develop new cities in Egypt's north coast on the Mediterranean Sea, west of the city of Alexandria. And the partnership agreement to develop Ras Al Hikma Peninsula is the largest ever foreign direct investment project in Egypt's history. Sir, before going into the details of the deal and the sums of money which are going to be invested and so, regarding not only the timing of signing the deal, regarding the difficulties which are facing the whole world, how do you see thinking out of the box of this kind of innovation, of studying or knowing more about our natural resources which can bring more direct and indirect investments, and in the same time to have these mutual benefits between us and our allies like the United Arab Emirates, of course, because this is going to be the fruitful result of this cooperation between us and them? Would you please elaborate?
It comes at a critical time. Mm-hmm. When we are seeing the world is suffering from the aftermath of the Ukrainian war and the COVID, and there is a recession in almost all the countries of the world. And when we look to a country like Egypt with a lot of natural resources which were not fully utilized or fully made use of, at a critical time when there is a crunch in the foreign reserves of many countries, Egypt is one of them, and we are in much need to not only dollars but also direct investment. Mm-hmm. When I say direct investment and you speak about $35 billion, mm-hmm. $35 billion, it is a big amount of money which is coming. It will come through some years, of course, not all of a sudden. 24 of it is coming directly, and this means that we are on the right course to use what we have of natural resources, or better use of what we have. This is one thing. Other thing is that when we see that the north coast in Egypt is a paradise by itself. Mm-hmm. We have seen most of it from Ras Al Hikma to El Salloum and Marsa Matruh, mm-hmm. and south to Siwa, and we find that we have a lot of natural resources which can be better used to bring more mm-hmm. tourists, bring money, employment, and at the same time raise the standard of living. That is the utmost of which we can do. The goal of any government is to raise the standard of living of the citizens. Now the process has begun, and we have to all support this process in every possible way and try in everyone in his sector to support and cement this trend of using our natural resources, and there are a lot of it, by the way. Mm-hmm. There are a lot of it, and you have to make, and you are in dire need now to make use of it for the dollars, we know about dollars, for the employment, for the standard of living, and also for invigorating the economy as a whole. With this as something we say invigorating the economy as well, so you are creating new areas of interest and new magnets for foreign investments to come and invest in this lucrative market. I say lucrative market because it is mutually beneficial for the investor. I will not say for Egypt first, but for the investor, mm-hmm. because they are running after their own interests, and we have a lot to offer foreign investors who come to Egypt at this time, especially in 2024, and there is a lot which they will see, and there is a lot which they enjoy with the atmosphere and environment which is investment friendly. And it is very important to have this investment friendly environment for the foreign investors, because this is what they are looking for, whether in regulations, in the bureaucracy, which is very important. At the same time, they're not only the regulations, but also the laws. And when we find that the president himself is encouraging and strongly encouraging and giving deadlines for implementation of certain measures to pacify and to attract the investors. That means that we are on the right course, and this is something very important, especially at this time, 2024.
He decided to be the head of the Supreme Council of Investment.
Yes.
I mean, or the Higher Council of Investments,
yes,
because he is going all the time to follow, I'm not going to say day by day, even minute by minute, what's going
yes
on, because if there are any obstacles on the way, they should be eliminated on the spot. But if you permit me, I'm going to speak a little bit about the numbers. Prime Minister Dr. Madbouly revealed during the press conference announcing the agreement that the $35 billion US dollars in foreign direct investment expected to be received in full within 2 months.
Only 2 months.
2 months.
Yes.
Okay. And will be distributed as follows: $24 billion in cash liquidity and $11 billion from UAE deposits at the Central Bank of Egypt, which will be converted into the Egyptian pounds and used for development work. The project is expected to attract up to $150 billion US dollars in investments throughout its development phase. So, how do you see the numbers and the way they are distributed and the way the Prime Minister announced them in the press conference?
When we are speaking about 2 months' time, 60 days time,
yeah,
and when we are speaking about $150 billion will be attracted, this means...
During its development phase,
during
because every word is important.
Yes.
During its development phase,
it is when,
meaning that it's only a stage,
yes,
only a phase, and
yes,
we are expecting more in the coming phases. True?
It is well true, and it is well prepared, the statement by the Prime Minister,
mm-hmm,
Dr. Mustafa Madbouly. What we are looking for, or for the implementation, it is very important that we are putting the words in practice, mm-hmm, putting it in the market, and so that the people will feel, will actually feel and see and enjoy the outcome of this influx of 24 or 35 or later on 150, and we are speaking about 2 months' time, just 8 weeks,
mm-hmm,
just 8 or 9 weeks. This means that a lot has been prepared, by the way.
Well prepared and studied,
yes,
before going to
before
the announcement.
Before going to the air, and that is something very important.
Mm-hmm.
When he said it within 60 days, this means that a lot of work has been done during the last months, will I say, or one or more than 1 year, to prepare the ground for the full implementation of what the Prime Minister said.
Mm-hmm.
That is very important for us,
sure,
and for the people, so that we create the needed confidence and trust in the Egyptian economy, which is badly needed,
mm-hmm,
at this time, because we need foreign currency, we need investment, and we need to invigorate and activate the economy after the recession, which you have seen in many countries of the world, but not Egypt, when it is the growth rate is almost 4.2%, and many countries of the world as either minus or just no, 0.5% or 1%, and the Egyptian economy is increasing by 4% or 4.2%. This means that a lot of work has been done, and a lot of work will be done.
Yes.
That is very important. And when the Prime Minister speaks about this short, very short span of time, this means that they are sure, and he is sure, that he will be able to implement it with this framework and with this timetable. And this is something very important for the investor and for also, I would say, for the local investor.
Mm-hmm.
I am always looking to the local investor, because the base is the local investor. When you are encouraging foreign investors, they are most welcome, of course, but at the same time, we are paving the way and increasing
at least
the chances.
Side by side.
Yes.
Because,
yes,
of course,
together,
the local investor, he is. They are very important, and they should have the lion's share.
Yes.
But there's all the time complementary efforts and joint efforts and joint activities together to come up with more positive results. And if we can speak about the reactions which took place just on the spot, Egyptian foreign bonds rose on the back of the deal announcement to becoming the best performing sovereign debt in emerging markets on Friday, meaning after just a few minutes, not few hours after the deal.
Yes.
The government dollar bonds maturing in 2051 jumped 4.5 cents on the dollar, recording a record jump according to Bloomberg data. And here we are mentioning Bloomberg data, it's not our data.
Yes.
Sir.
This means that what has been done on the ground is directly reflected and promptly reflected on the evaluation of foreign investors and foreign foreign organizations which are seeing about the economy, how is this going. Mm-hmm. When we are seeing, whether it is Moody's or whatever, when they are saying that the Egyptian economy is on the right course and the prospects are stable, the word stable is very important, and the in a positive way, this means that we are on the right course and a lot of homework has been done. Without they do not speak about it, of the homework. We see the result now. Mm-hmm. When we speak about 2 months' time for implementing this big, it is fairly big project, mm-hmm. fairly big project, and at a very important location in Egypt, in the north coast. Mm-hmm. And where Ras El Hikma will be a place which will be a magnet for more investors to come in the very near future. When I say the very near future, I mean 2024 and 2025. We will see the results and we will enjoy the results, and the Egyptian economy will keep its steady growth for the year to, for
you
many
mentioned
years
a
plus.
Very important point, sir, before going into more reactions from the international economic entities like the IMF, for example. You said the word stable is very important.
Yes.
Because I do remember a very important statement which was released by His Excellency Minister of Finance, Dr. Mohammed Maid,
yes.
when there was some reports which were released by some of those entities degrading our economy or going from a degree to a lower degree. He told them, please, when you are evaluating our economy, consider the surrounding circumstances. Consider what we are going through before going just that easy, taking our economy from this grade to another grade. And this is the word stable is something great when it comes yes. to challenges and changes as we are all witnessing, if you agree with me on that.
Egypt is facing many challenges in many areas. Still, it is able to keep a stable economy, positive growth and expansion in many areas, and creating new areas or new magnets for foreign investors. This is something phenomenal, thanks to Minister of Finance Mohammed Maid, who highlighted that when any organization is looking to the economy, should not look out from one angle, but should look for the 180 degrees angle. That is to say, there are a lot of work has been done. There are a lot of challenges which are being faced, and also there are risks of security in Sinai and in the Western Desert and in Sudan. This affects the economy in some way or other. And still, the Egyptian economy is stable.
Sir, simply give me one country in the whole world where all its strategic directions or all the strategic borders are on fire.
On fire.
Anyways, for example, since we mentioned that, today, President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi received his Eritrean counterpart, Assiasi Afwerki. And among the topics which were discussed, the security situation in the Red Sea. Even if we are going to mention this insecure navigation route and how it has such a negative impact on Egypt, I think that's enough not to let any of the international economic institutions like Moody, like S&P, wherever, to dare to downgrade Egypt's economy. Egypt is living amongst all this, and still, as you've kindly mentioned, we are maintaining our economy stable, or at least as far as we can. True?
This means that the economy is on the Egyptian economy is on the right course. Mm-hmm. I mentioned challenges. One of it you rightly mentioned now about the Red Sea route and what is happening in Bab al-Mandab and the challenges which are faced or created by certain countries in the area, regardless of what is the impact on the Egyptian economy or the international trade.
Yes. The international trade, yes. The price of oil, energy crisis, chain supply,
a lot of things.
You name it.
A lot of things, in fact. They mention Gaza and what is happening in Gaza, and this will not affect Gaza, by the way, in any way. This will not, they are just hitting some ships, British or American or whatever, and all other ships is changing its route to the Cape of Good Hope, and there is end result is that the Egyptian economy is
are
facing
they going to be able to bear this very heavy
expensive.
Burden?
Yes, it is
an
expensive.
Expensive burden of having this amount of oil, which they should have to have all the whole way along. I doubt. But let's return back to the IMF deal, for example, and this reaction after the deal which was announced yesterday. Madbouly said during the press conference that the agreement puts Egypt very few steps away from reaching a new agreement with the International Monetary Fund, as Goldman Sachs expected the deal to provide sufficient liquidity alongside the large IMF program to cover Egypt's financing gap over the next 4 years.
When we reach an agreement with the IMF, this means many things. Not the agreement itself, what I care for, but its impact on other investors and would-be lenders. Mm-hmm. Because once we reach an agreement with the IMF, this means it is a green signal to other creditors that Egypt is a stable country and they can invest in Egypt and they can lend in Egypt to cover this very limited time deficiency in foreign currencies, and we mentioned the 21 or $35 billion which are coming, and at the same time we add to it the IMF agreement with the IMF, whether it is $10 billion or whatever, it will cover the dire needs now. This means that Egyptian economy is able to face the challenges and succeed in surmounting the challenges which you have seen in Sinai or in the Red Sea or in other parts. So a lot of challenges at the same time.
And the duration of time, it's not in years.
Yes.
And let's reassure that Goldman Sachs believes that the deal will be a supportive factor for the Egyptian pound and will provide Egypt with an opportunity to regain liquidity in the foreign exchange market in the coming days or weeks.
Days or weeks.
Not even months.
The impact is spontaneous.
Mm-hmm.
We see it, the impact on the market is very important. When we see that the price of dollar is escalating without any reason for that, and at the same time the government and the IMF and the other institutions are supporting Egypt because they trust. The Egyptian government, and they have confidence in the Egyptian economy. This means that we are on the right course. It is a matter of time, and the time is limited time.
Mm-hmm.
It's very limited when we are speaking about days and weeks. This did not happen before.
Mm-hmm.
Before it was months and years, but now it is days and weeks, and the influx of the liquidity is very important at this time of the year. And we will see the impact on the price of dollar in the free market or in the official rate.
And I'm going to repeat that because many people are not going to believe so. The deal signed between the two governments foresees the injection of a first tranche of $15 billion over the next week. The next week. With a second tranche of $20 billion following within the next 2 months. Meaning next week and in the following 60 days, that's it.
We are speaking about February and March. This means that also at the same time, the needs of importation of goods for Ramadan will be covered, will be well covered, thanks to this this deal, which comes at a critical time and the appropriate time, and it is in a very short time, we'll see a couple of weeks, we'll see the results. And I think that the markets will feel the result of this deal within
on the ground
in March, that is in Ramadan, months of Ramadan, inshallah. We will see the result. And we are entering Ramadan with confidence the situation will be far better than what it is today, inshallah.
Sir, as I said in my intro, this is the fruitful result of cooperation between us and our allies. And of course, when it comes to the United Arab Emirates, they are of the closest allies to Egypt for such a long time, since Sheikh Zayed, may God bless his soul. Sir, I'd like to have or to give examples to our viewers, as what we are witnessing is something which was repeated more than once among other allies, not only Egypt and our allies. I mean, as I really want to describe it as usual, a win-win situation. For example, we, of course, reclaim our lands and we are aiming to cultivate tens or even hundreds of thousands of hectares. But when there is in Rwanda, for example, very fertile lands, yes, already ready, yes, to be cultivated, but they don't know how to do it in the best way, we can help. So it's our expertise and their land, and it's going to be a win-win situation. And this is exactly what happened with many of our African allies. Simply, this is another side or another idea of the very same concept. How do you see this as a must? Because it's not a luxury anymore to avoid or to neglect such chances, because all of us are in need of such ideas to be implemented for on the ground for the best interests of both. Would you please, sir, I'd like you to elaborate on that.
That is when we see that the African countries are coming to Egypt to see how did it developed very quickly in this or that sector, this, and they are asking for our experience in that, and our experts go to Rwanda and other countries in Africa, in South Africa, in Southern Africa, to make use of their experience, which they gained on the ground in Egypt. That's why the African countries are coming to Egypt, because they have seen results, mm-hmm, concrete results on the ground. This is one thing. Other thing is that, regarding the United Arab Emirates, we are seeing fruitful investment by United Arab Emirates in Egypt in several, this is not only Ras Al Hikmah, but in other sectors also. Mm-hmm. This means that they are sure that the return of the investment in Egypt is higher than in other countries in the world. That's, they are looking for own interest, of course. This is a win-win situation. And when they are choosing Egypt to invest or to pour more investment, this means that they are sure that they can have more profits from this lucrative market. I say lucrative market is 110 million consumers for all aspects of life. And this means that the lucrative market is a good magnet for big investments. And the United Arab Emirates stepped, it was the right step in the right direction to invest in Ras Al Hikmah, and more will come very soon, because they are sure that they have better returns for investments in this market. That's something very important. Mm-hmm. This is one thing. Other thing is that when we look to the whole picture of the Egyptian economy, mm-hmm, and we see that during the last 6 or 7 years, many challenges were there. I mentioned Sinai and Libya and Sudan, and recently we've seen Sudan, what is happening, and what is happening in the Nile. And this means that we are facing the challenges, and we are facing it. Mm-hmm. We are not avoiding it, but we are facing it and succeeding in, will I say, overtaking all the challenges which we have taken. That's something very important. When we are speaking about the investment in the north, in the North Coast, or investment in Sinai, or investment in the Western Desert, this means that a lot of lucrative, attractive points of investment are there in Egypt, and also the Red Sea, by the way. Mm-hmm. All this until Bernice in the and the Marsa Alam in the south. all these locations are attracting more investors to come and we are seeing NEOM on the other part side of the Red Sea. But when we go to Hurghada or Marsa Alam or Bernice on the Red Sea, and we see that investors are coming on a stable ground, and they are coming not only with investments but with the tourists.
Yes.
This is what we care for. Many of them, or I've seen it in Hurghada, are buying houses and dwellings on the Red Sea and living there. They are pensioners or whatever, and they come with their money to invest in Egypt by buying dwellings and buying apartments and buildings in this part of the Red Sea. I think that's just the Red Sea. Mm-hmm. I did not speak about the Western Desert and Marsa Matruh and Siwa, where a lot of tourists are coming from Germany to Siwa every year just to stay a couple of weeks and enjoy the salt lakes in Siwa. This is one example. A lot of attractions are in Egypt, and it needs better marketing. Mm-hmm. I'm speaking about marketing our economy and our attractions is very important, not only for the economy and the employment, but also for overall image of Egypt overseas. Mm-hmm. We are selling the correct and the positive image in the European market, in the Eastern European market, and in the United States. And I've seen a lot of investors are asking what we can do, how we can do it, and when we can do it, and how much. These are very important questions which I receive from investors from European countries or Western countries, not only European, the Western countries. And when they come to Egypt, they find that there are more opportunities than they were dreaming of.
Yes.
So this is what we are selling.
Egypt is very rich, but what we lack, or what we were lacking, to be accurate, I think that it's getting better a day after the other. Management, marketing, and that's it. To study well, or to have the visibility study before going through any new project, it's very important. You know, sir, I heard a statement, I think maybe 10 years ago, from a German expert.
Yes.
Who said that when he visited the New Valley or El Wadi El Jadid,
yes,
governorate, he said that only with the winds there, with the energy of winds.
Just the
energy of winds.
Yes.
In El Wadi El Jadid alone, it can be the source of energy to Germany as a whole. So if we can just manage our resources, natural resources, the wind, the sun, you name it, we are going to be on top of the emerging economies and moving forward from being a developing country to a developed country. Despite the fact that I'm going to say that only as examples, and I'd like you, sir, if you permit me to comment on that. If you read just any economic news today,
yes,
you are going to find that Eiffel Tower in France was closed because of a strike of its staff, because they want to raise in their pay. The farmers in Poland, in all Europe, Poland, France, Italy, they were also striking because of, let's say, financial issues. Third, or last but not least, the main air carrier in Germany, also they were on a strike, and many flights were cancelled because of such issues. So, regarding the global economy, the developed countries are suffering exactly or even more than the developing countries.
Yes.
But unfortunately, many people, they do not read or they do not want to know except about the local economic crisis.
People, when we are looking to only one angle, as I mentioned earlier, this means that have a distorted version or the total picture of what we have.
Yes.
I should look to 180 degrees so that I better evaluate what I'm seeing in Egypt.
Mm-hmm.
When you are seeing German investors are coming to Egypt to invest in areas which are known but not well known. They come, they stay for a couple of weeks or some months and find that this is a lucrative investment environment and investment place and investment sector for exporting. Exporting is the word, export is very lovely, which I like.
Sure.
Exporting energy to Germany.
Yes.
And we know what is happening from the, after the Russian mm-hmm. invasion of Ukraine and what happened for in the energy sector, in especially in Germany and the Western European countries,
yes.
and what is happening in Ukraine. Mm-hmm. When we see that they are having a stable source of energy, this encourages them, a stable government, investment friendly atmosphere and in Egypt, in the environment, mm-hmm. and at the same time the regulations are supportive to foreign investors, and they come to see that they can do more than they what they are thinking of.
Mm-hmm.
This means that I have a lot of attractive points for investors to come and invest and export to Germany and the other countries.
And if you permit me, we do have the upper hand, simply because we are the owners of these treasures, of these wealths. We are the richer, the more rich country.
Yeah,
well, sir, because we do have a lot to speak about, also another big event took place this week, which was Egypt's, this exhibition, which was held under the slogan of Energy in Action, as we were talking about energy, supply security, energy conversion, emissions reduction. And during the inauguration, which took place last Monday, President Sisi said implementing renewable energy pledges in Africa is difficult due to lack of funding, calling on international financing institutions and rich countries to provide low-cost funding to renewable energy projects. And I think this call, it's not only for our African allies, it's also for the northern side of the Mediterranean. True?
True. And when the president himself highlighted that the developed countries undertook to pay $100 billion for the energy sector in the African continent, and it did not materialize. This means that a big burden is thrown on the shoulders of the African countries who are doing their best in the energy sector. And Egypt is at the same time is lucky enough to be a hub for energy in the Middle East and in the southern part of the Mediterranean.
Mm.
We have our experience in this field, and that is why the president himself has spoken to these Egyptics and highlighted the importance of cooperation between developed and developing countries in lowering the cost of energy production and green energy and all types of energy. There are wind energy, the water energy, and the sun energy. These are sources which are not fully utilized. And Egypt is lucky enough that, as you mentioned earlier, in the Western Desert, the wind energy and also the sun. We have sun almost 11 months a year. It can be exported, simple like that.
Sure.
So investment,
or at least cover our local market
first step,
at least.
We are self-sufficient in energy, almost. But we can have a surplus, and at some times we exported electricity or energy to the Saudi Arabia
mm-hmm.
and to Jordan at some stage.
Mm-hmm.
Now we are in the process of establishing new points for exportation of energy or electricity to these countries again, and Germany is the one of the first beneficiaries of investing in this area, and we will see a lot of other companies from Italy are coming now to see how, from Italy. I mentioned exactly Italy because they are coming.
Because they had a very, very successful
yes.
Experience here with Dhuhr.
Yes.
Eni. One
with Eni, yes.
Yeah.
With Eni, yes.
Yeah.
And so they have the experience in the Egyptian market. And when I say Egyptian market, I see land market and the Mediterranean Sea market, which is very important for the Italian investor, and there are a lot of money which does not find a place, and now they are coming to this lucrative market where they will invest, and they can invest, I would say they can invest, and we should do all the needful steps so that they come and stay and invest in the energy and export it to Europe.
And to echo what you have just said, Sir President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi met on the sidelines of Egypt with BP CEO as the president lauded BP's outstanding activities, the size and scope of its growing investments in Egypt, as well as its exploration projects in the oil and gas sector. And this is one example.
One of the biggest companies of the world is British Petroleum. Hmm? When the president of the chairman, CEO, comes to see the president of Egypt, this means that there is something concrete which he wants and which he can achieve through cooperation in Egypt. And we have every point to make benefit of this meeting, which is very important for us, especially in the energy sector and also in exportation of electricity to Europe. And there are established lines now which are being under the Mediterranean Sea, which are going to European market, whether through Italy and Greece to Germany. And there is a lot which will be done, and we wait to increase the areas of cooperation with the European market and the countries of European Union, so that they need Egypt and Egypt needs them.
This is what we call a strategic partnership.
Yes.
Well, sir, as usual, I enjoyed our discussion. Thank you
Me too. Very much
for your input, sir. And inshallah, we are going to leave you with the promise to see you again in more episodes. We were very much delighted and honored to have with us live here in the studio, my dear guest,
His Excellency
Ambassador Ayoub Mahmoud Ayoub, former Minister of Commercial. Thank you, sir.
Thanks a lot.
We are going to leave now with some of the most important economic news which took place in the past 7 days. And by this, we come to the end of our episode. Till we meet again at the same time on Mal TV International. Many thanks for watching. And this was Nirmin Abdurrahman.